that is called as integral theorems. You have, we have two theorems over here which play a vital role in the study of electromagnetics. The integral theorems. Integral theorems. We have to go through two theorems. Okay, before directly giving you the theorems, I'll just give you two statements over here. The first statement is, if I consider few lines and if I close them. So what I mean is closed lines. For example, if I take four lines and if I close them, what I am getting? I am getting a surface. So remember, a closed line gives you a surface, an open surface. So closed line will give me an open surface. So as we have seen over here, that when I have considered four lines and if I draw a closed figure from that, it will give me a surface, rectangle. Here it is giving me a rectangle. Similarly, if I consider few surfaces and if I close them, for example, if I consider a room, so a room has six walls. So what I have done, I have closed all the six walls. Therefore, I formed a room, and inside the room I have volume. So therefore, always remember that closed surface will give me a volume, and volume is always open. So just for the sake of completion, let me write it as open volume. So closed line will give me an open surface, and closed surface will give me an open volume. Now, whenever I'll consider closed line to open surface, so this can be done using curl operation. And whenever I have closed surface and I have to draw an open volume, I will use divergence. Now this is nothing but, this is Stokes' law, Stokes' theorem, and this is divergence theorem. If I write them in terms of, in mathematical terms, so what I have said, closed line. So that means I have to use a closed loop here. This circle represent closed. So it is line. So I need to consider line integral. So A vector dot dl vector. And as I have to, as we have seen, it will give me an open surface. And while using that, I need to use curl. So it will be del cross A dot into ds vector. This is Stokes' theorem. That means if I consider a closed line integral, I'll get a surface which is open. So therefore, I have not used a circle over here. Next, if I write the divergence theorem similarly, so it will be A vector dot ds vector, that is closed surface, will give me an open volume. So del dot A vector into dv. So closed surface will give me a volume. This is nothing but Stokes' theorem, and this is nothing but divergence theorem. This is also called as Gauss divergence theorem. So these two theorems are very important. Just consider, let's take one or two problems which have appeared in the previous GATE examination. Let me consider this problem. Question is, the direction of A vector is radially outward. Is radially outward from the origin. With mod of A vector is equal to k into r power n, where r square is equal to x square plus y square plus z square, and k is a constant. The value of n for which del dot A vector is equal to 0 is, options are minus 2, B2, C0 and D1. Now if you read the question carefully, here it is given that there is a vector A and whose direction is radially outward from the origin, and also its magnitude is given to you. Now, whenever you get the term radially outward and it is with respect to origin, so it must be, you must think about spherical coordinate system. So in spherical coordinate system, this vector A, spherical coordinate system, this A vector is given by, its magnitude is already given to me, so it will be k into r power n, and since it is radially outward its direction, so therefore it is AR vector, because AR vector is radially outward. So A vector is k into r power n into AR vector. Now here what he has asked, that for del dot A equal to 0, what will be the value of, what will be the value of n? Now I have given you the generalized formula. From the generalized formula, if you substitute the values of h1, h2, h3 and u, v, w, the formula for divergence in spherical coordinate system will appear like this. So I have told you to the students, please replace all the scaling factors h1, h2, h3 and u, v, w with their respective values, and you will get this formula. So del dot A will be 1 by r square d by dr r square ar plus 1 by r sine theta d by d theta into sine theta a theta plus 1 by r sine theta d by d phi d a phi by d phi. So this formula is straightforward. You can easily get this formula once you substitute the values of h1, h2, h3 and u, v, w in the generalized formula of divergence. And you need to solve it a bit. It's very easy. So you can get this formula. Just make the manual. Just do it on a paper. You'll get it. Or you can refer some book to in order to understand this. Let's not waste the time in that. Now here A vector consists of only R component. So therefore in this you will not have the variation with respect to d theta as well as d phi. So you will have only this AR component. You do not have A theta component and A phi component. Therefore this two will straightforward become 0. This and this will become 0. Why? Because we do not have A theta component, A phi component. We have only AR vector. Now therefore del dot A vector will be given by 1 by r square d by dr r square into, what is given in the problem? The magnitude is k into r power n, and it must be equal to 0. So what will be the value of n for this? So this r square will become 0. Now this k is a constant, so I can take it outside the differentiation. So I will left with d by dr into r power n plus 2 is equal to 0. Now, what will be the value of n plus 2 so that I'll get the differentiation? So we know that if you differentiate something and if you want to get the value of 0, then it must be a constant. So in order to make it as a constant, this n plus 2, this must be equal to 0. Then only r power 0 will be 1. And then the differential will give you 0. So n plus 2 must be equal to 0. This implies n must be equal to minus 2. Please understand the meaning of this. If n is equal to minus 2, then this will become r power 0. And r power 0, it means 1. So if you differentiate 1 with respect to r, you will get 0. So therefore, n must be equals to minus 2 in order to make this, make the divergence of A vector as 0. Let me consider one more problem based on the theorems. So there is a question here. A vector is given to you. So A vector is AX vector plus X square AY vector. We have to find closed interval A vector dot DL vector over the path, and the path is given by this. This is the path. So along this path, I have to calculate the A dot DL. Now, this is 1 by root 3, this is 2 by root 3, this is 1, this is 2, and this is 3. This is x, this is y, and 0. Your options are 0, 1, 2 by root 3, and d is 2 root 3. Now you have to find closed interval a dot dl along this path. You observe that by using Stokes theorem, you can directly use the Stokes theorem over here. If you try to solve this side, this closed interval a dot dl, then you need to solve four integrals. But instead, if you apply Stokes theorem, so using Stokes theorem, we have closed interval A vector dot DL vector is equal to open interval del cross A. Del cross A vector into DS vector. Now, so using this relation, if you find del cross A, and if you use the right hand side in order to calculate this integral, it will be much simpler. It will take less time. So therefore, first let me calculate del cross A. So del cross A vector is equal to, so using that generalized formula, if I substitute the values of h1, h2, h3 and uvw, the formula will be AY vector AZ vector d by dx d by dy d by dz. Here you need to substitute the values of AX, AY and AZ. So here AX is XY, AY is X square and this is 0. Now if I solve this, I'll get x into a z vector. Just solve it. It's simple determinant, so you can solve it easily. So I've got x a z vector as the del cross a value. Now using the RHS, so now I can calculate surface integral del cross a into ds. Now when I take the dot product, I'll left with z component only. So what I'll do is I'll take the surface integral. So whenever you have to consider surface integral, you must consider double integral. So double integral, you have x into az vector, and here in this surface integral you have to take the surfaces. So when you consider the surface integral, you will consider the surface only which has z component. So you have dx dy az component. So it is z constant surface. You have to consider z constant surface. And also your x is varying from 1 by root 3 to 2 by root 3, and your y varies from 1 to 3. If you solve this integral, it's very easy. If you solve this integral, you will get the answer as 1. So this is very good application of using Stokes' law, Stokes' theorem. Similarly, so you can solve the LHS side, LHS also, left hand side, and you can verify the result at home. And I request you to do the same, and you will observe how easy it is to you find the value of that integral using the right hand side alone. Sometimes it may be useful to use the left hand side because many integrals will become zero, but mostly this right hand side is more useful than the left hand side.